Now this week's feature story. Today we bring you part 4 of our series Asians in the 21st Century, in which we introduce people who are working to usher in social changes to greet the new century in Asia.
Is this someone from India?
That's right, her name is Jyoti Mhapsekar and she comes from the western Indian state of Maharashtra.
She looks small, but it looks like she's taking up a big challenge.
Yes, Jyoti is the leader of a theater group. Their aim is not just to entertain, but to fight discrimination against women. Jyoti travels across the country. Let's take a look at her activities.
The crowd on this street corner in Mumbai have gathered to watch a comedy performance. This man sings, "If you can produce sons, then marrying them off is a really good business. You'll make lots of money. And that's all that matters. Don't worry about their feelings." At first glance, this may look like an ordinary show based on light comedy, but the underlying theme is the abuse suffered by women in India. The play takes aim at the traditional customs still inherent in Indian society, such as wife beating and violence toward women over their dowries.
Get out of here!
No, I have a right to stay in this house.
Say that after you get the money from your father.
I can't.
Then you'll die.
And so the poor bride is killed. The troupe is led by 50-year-old Jyoti Mhapsekar, who also wrote the basic script for the play. Since it was first staged 25 years ago, it's been translated into 8 of India's different languages and has been performed over 2,000 times across the country. The play is actually just one of the activities of Jyoti's group. The actors are all volunteers, and they include some of the few Indian women who've actually received a higher education. Most of them have regular full-time jobs, such as doctors or teachers. Some men jeer the performances, since they call for gender equality, but more and more male audiences are starting to stay and watch. And needless to say, women support them overwhelmingly.
It was really good. My sister is in the same situation.
In India, women are discriminated against. We must also encourage women to start thinking of themselves as second-class citizens. We cannot wait forever for our apathetic government to take action. Comedy is the most effective way to convey our message, especially for people who cannot read or write.
Jyoti may not look strong, but she's full of energy. To broaden the scope of her campaign, she's always listening to what women have to say. Trains in India have separate cars for men and women, so Jyoti takes advantage of this system whenever she travels by train. She listens in to women's conversations. This helps her come up with new ideas for her scripts. Some of the women seek advice from Jyoti once they find out what she does. Jyoti spends little time at rest. Act and decide quickly is her motto. This is the office of the volunteer group which Jyoti set up to help women become more independent. Every day, from late afternoon and through the evening, Jyoti and her staff discuss ways to expand the group's activities. They try to keep in close touch with other NGOs so they can work together. When Jyoti founded her group 25 years ago, it had just 5 members. Now there are some 300 people involved.
Well, I'm hoping that I'll soon be able to hand over the running of our group to the younger generation of volunteers.
Rape and murder linked to dowry. Pregnant wife killed by husband. Young girl found in garbage bin. Headlines like this can be seen in Indian newspapers all too often. Despite India's global success in many areas of science and technology, especially computer engineering, many anachronistic customs remain alive in Indian society, and women are expected to obey men's orders unconditionally. These customs are particularly embedded in poorer areas and among the lower classes. Many women in India spend their entire lives doing nothing but raising their children and working around their homes. Very few people are sympathetic to the idea of women being given an education or playing a role in society. The most extreme feudal custom which stands in the way of modernization is the dowry system, which is practiced throughout the country. The family of a bride often has to pay a dowry several times its annual income and also make expensive gifts to the groom's family. With the rapid economic growth of the 1990s, the amounts demanded for dowries have also soared. The situation is worst among the urban poor. Reports of women being beaten or killed by their husbands for being unable to meet dowry demands are common. Often the bride's family are also in physical danger, but many women have been forced to silently bear their pain as part of the social norm.
I have to do this because my husband won't work. I don't have any choice.
When my husband gets drunk, he beats me with a stick. Sometimes he chases me with a knife. See this wound? I got this when he stabbed me with a burning stick.
My husband's brother and his friend tried to rape me. I could get killed, but the police won't help me.
I don't remember anything. If you try to sue me, you'll be sorry.
Okay, let's talk this over.
There's nothing to talk about. I haven't done anything wrong.
Sure, I hit my wife sometimes, but it's no big deal.
For Hindu people, this book is like their Bible. The Ordinances of Manu gives guidance on all aspects of people's lives and also stipulates how women should behave. These are some of its commandments. Women should never act on their own initiative. Young girls must obey their fathers. Wives must obey their husbands. Widows must obey their firstborn sons. Women must never be independent. Both of Jyoti's parents were activists who campaigned for India's independence. She was raised in a home that was free of such prejudice. But when she began going to school, she realized that other Indian homes were different from hers. She began to question why women should have such a subordinate status. So at college, she majored in sociology. She began working as an activist in 1975, which the United Nations declared the International Year of Women. She has attended women's conferences in China and Australia and continues to expand her network of contacts. Every day she gathers and exchanges information via the internet. This helps both her script writing and her NGO group.
At least 5 to 6. From various parts of the world. Because I work on the Managing Committee of Women Playwright International.